the fifth year after the death of Christ, the Council of the High Priests in Jerusalem was still striving to eradicate all memory of the Nazarene. The teachings of Jesus were spreading all over Judea, thanks to the clandestine efforts of the apostles who traveled the land, spreading the word and appointing deacons to help organize their followers. The deacon in Jerusalem was an outspoken young man named Stephen.
Faith is the evidence of things not seen. Faith humbles us and helps us accept what can never be explained. But what is the use of faith if all that surrounds us is clear and solid to touch? Moses told the Israelites, God will raise up for you a prophet like me from your own people. Our ancestors refused to obey him. Instead, they rejected him and in their hearts turned back to Egypt. Nothing has changed since the time of Moses. But those in our temple today have little faith. They have refused the prophet raised by God from their own people. They ignored the prophet to perform wonders and signs. They crucified the Son of God.
Arrest him.
The most perfect nectarines.
My nectarines are indeed very good.
You are Nathaniel? I am Levi. This is my daughter, Johanna. We have been traveling for 4 days from Damascus.
Go get them some nectarines.
Peace be with you. He's not of the world, but he's a good man. I am too old to care for the farm on my own. He helps. How can I help you, brother?
We seek a man, perhaps you know him. His name is Stephen.
Many have come forward to testify as to your blasphemies, that you believe that Jesus of Nazareth was the Son of God, able to forgive sins.
Lord Caiaphas, which the prophets did in your father's persecute. You follow in their footsteps. You resist the Holy Spirit. You killed those who foretold the coming of the righteous one. And you have now become betrayers and murderers.
It keeps us together as one people. It is what unites us against Rome and helps us bear their tyranny and injustice. Why would you want to take this away from us?
Forgiveness is our strength, not weakness.
When you talk of forgiveness, do you intend us to forgive all our enemies, including Rome?
He said love one another.
Including Rome.
Love one another.
Sins are forgiven only by God. Yet you believe the Nazarene could forgive sins.
He still does, and will do so to the end of time. It was his gift to us, for he was of God.
Why do you blaspheme like this? I have tried to reason with you, but you continue to insult me. Why do you insist on spreading falsehoods, inciting people to reject what for us is... what for us is sacred? You are a traitor to your own people. Get him out of my sight.
Can you have search for this man.
Yes.
Miss Stephen, he is your husband.
I'm not married.
Beta.
No, I live with my father.
Stephen, you speak up. He is a traitor. How do you mean?
One stone can bring down all that is holy. We have seen one stone, a carpenter from Nazareth who chose to destroy rather than build, who wanted to tear down our temple rather than fortify it, blaspheme our laws rather than honor them. For you stands a second stone, and if we do not crush it today, it will double and triple until it sweeps over us like a plague.
Thank you.
will not rest with Stephen. We must leave.
Yes, I know.
Just gather what you need and come with us, but you must hurry.
And where will you go?
Damascus. It is under Roman law, not temple law. Sanhedrin will have no jurisdiction there. They will not harm us there.
It's a 4-day journey. It's too hard for me.
You cannot stay here.
I'm an old man. They wouldn't bother with me.
No, Nathaniel, you are wrong.
If I come with you, I'll slow you down, and you must hurry. Should already have left. Now go. I'll take care of myself.
Let's go.
Couldn't the measure of mercy have been the wiser part?
Mercy for whom?
We condemned a follower of the Nazarene that was crucified years ago. They both died uttering words of forgiveness, defying our law. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth.
I forgive you.
By lawfully executing Stephen, we have created the first martyr in the name of the Nazarene.
Well, what would you have us do, Gamaliel? Shall we allow blasphemers freely to walk our streets? Shall we suspend the laws of Moses?
My advice is to ignore these followers, for if the movement is of human origin, like many others before it, it will collapse on its own. But if it is from God, no man, Roman or Jew, can stop it.
What Gamaliel counsels is wise. I know because I have been his student since I was a boy. We owe deference to his age and wisdom. He is right. If this movement of followers is of God, then no man can stop it. But what if it is not? Does the shepherd stand by while the wolf attacks his flock and call it God's will? Does the physician turn away and let the patient die and call it God's will? No. I put it to you that our faith is under attack by those who pervert the laws of God for the sake of this self-proclaimed chosen one. Chosen for what? To tear down our temple, his own words. Let God be the judge if our actions are just.
We must strike this poison and cut it out before it infects the body of our nation.
I too have taken an oath. I will not watch our faith die and call it the will of God. I will be the tip of his sword. I will not stand by.
You are playing a dangerous game.
The preservation of our faith is no game. We must both decide whose side we are on.
Side? This is not a matter of side.
Enough, Gamaliel. Saul, you know what you must do. You have the blessing of the council. God is with you.
Consider this a misunderstanding. Stand, be gone.
Why do you arrest this man? To work for him.
He's a follower of the Nazarene, a blasphemer. I have orders to bring him to the temple to stand trial.
No, he is a good man.
That will be determined by others, not by you or me. What about you? Are you a follower? Are you a follower of the Nazarene?
Men and women, but a real threat to our survival as Jews, the people of God. They would have you believe that the Nazarene was the Messiah. But I ask you, are we free people? We are still answering to pagan laws and masters. We are still struggling against foreign tyranny. Declaring Jesus of Nazareth the Messiah is nothing short of treason. For they would rather bow their heads in submission than rally with their own people to fight for our freedom. Deny he is the prophecy Messiah.
No, I cannot.
Denounce this Nazarene, deny he is the Son of God, and tonight you will sleep in your own bed.
I have nothing left. The work of the Nazarene's my only hope.
We have offered them mercy, and they reject it!
Brought before this council on charges of blasphemy. You will be kept in chains and beaten until you come to your right minds.
Joseph saw you at the Damascus and ran to tell me right away. So glad to see you.
It's been a long 4 days' journey from Jerusalem.
Come, come to my house. You must rest. Please, all of you, come.
Butcher of Judea is rounding up anyone suspected of being a follower.
A butcher of Judea? Is that what Saul is being called?
It's caused much grief in Jerusalem.
But we have nothing to fear, do we? The Lord will protect us all.
Oh, I came here the moment I received news that you'd arrived in Damascus. I'm so relieved you are here.
Johanna, it's so good to see you. How's your father?
He is well. Do you happen to know what became of the young man who worked for Nathaniel? He walked with a limp.
Was he the one that was with you when...
Why do you stop? Continue. When my husband Stephen was stoned to death, murdered, and nobody helped. Abandoned to die like a criminal. Is that what's to become of us? To die like criminals, stoned or crucified?
No, Esther. That is not our fate.
Then why have we run away?
At first, it was easy. No one knew we were coming, and people would inform on them, especially if it meant saving themselves or taking over their neighbor's land.
The word has spread.
Many have fled north to Damascus, where they believe they can live more openly under Roman rule.
I doubt very much that the Romans would appreciate our guards marching into their city.
I have Roman lineage.
And am therefore a Roman citizen. Nothing can stop me from entering Damascus.
As far as the Tower Guard is concerned, all I need is an official request from you asking the governor to allow us into the city to weed out threats to the security of Rome.
So be it.
My men are eager to serve you. I, on the other hand, am not so certain of taking orders from someone I used to knock about in school.
I can't believe they made you a captain.
Stranger than you, a Pharisee.
God has smiled upon both of us.
Yes. Well, I keep my hand on my sword just in case he turns his back. Now, what is this talk I hear of dangerous rebels in Damascus?
The cult of the Nazarene. I've never seen anything like it.
Well, there's always some charlatan ready to preach to the weak. Stay strong. That's all you can do.
No, that is not all you can do. You can fight back. Root it out and destroy its insidious message before it infects us all. There must be no faltering, no hesitation.
Well, you know you can count on me.
Yes, as a friend. But I need to know that I can count on you as a soldier in my command.
I am the soldier, so I know how to give orders and how to take them. Slate, as much prepared. I'll return to my men.
Captain, we are doing God's work.
That is an issue that is above my rank. I forgive you.
What did you just say?
Say?
Just now as you were going, you said, I forgive you. Forgive me of what?
I said nothing.
I heard you clear as day.
So, I didn't say anything. Good night. For your daughter's hand in marriage.
I'm sorry, I did not have time for lectures. Now I have an answer to give.
I'm about to leave for the master.
Only a word with your teacher, soul. Remember that the people you seek are our brethren. They are Jews, like you and me. They do not carry any weapons.
No disrespect, Rabbi, but I cannot leave my men waiting.
Your men? Once the Sanhedrin were the guardians of the temple. Now it seems they are the personal guard of Saul of Tarsus.
I act on behalf of the temple. I have only the power granted to me by the high priests. I take their counsel in all things.
Then perhaps you should seek less the counsel of men and more the counsel of God.
And where might that voice come from you?
I would never presume to speak for God. Don't make that mistake yourself.
To learn more about what Nathaniel and Stephen talked about, because I think that they chose to die rather than only do that when they know the truth. Will you teach me?
Also a Sanhedrin guard.
We all have a past, Johanna. We can't change that. But what's important is what lies ahead.
He says he loves me.
You feel the same?
We've only known each other a short time.
It'll be one of the shortest courtships I ever knew.
My father agrees to the marriage.
How do you feel?
I feel safe with him. Have you ever loved a man that way?
I have.
But you never marry? Mary, is something wrong?
Why are we talking about me when it's useless getting married?